The big question is how the nervous system controls movement. And many of our movements are organized in a way in which they're very repetitive. So the simple examples of that include things like breathing, very repetitive, or simply walking down the sidewalk, just alternating your legs as you take steps. So we set up a series of experiments where we could ask what kinds of neurons are involved in repetitive movements. So we monitored that process, and we're on the lookout for repetitive firing. All of these experiments that I have described and that are included in this particular report are considered in vitro experiments because the cells were grown, cultured in plastic dishes. From that, what we were able to do is combine different ratios of cell types and study the properties of the rhythmicity of the circuit. And that rhythmicity could be very tightly controlled depending on the cellular composition of the neural networks that we were forming. So we could regulate the speed, which is kind of equivalent to controlling how fast you're walking. And we could also control more complicated aspects of the circuit. I would say that it's an overstep to claim it's a brain, but it's a little part of the computational unit that is used by the brain. The name that we have coined is circuitoid. There are a variety of neurodegenerative diseases. Some that people might be familiar with, of course, are Alzheimer's disease, Parkinson's disease, ALS, the disease that was centered around the ice bucket challenge, and also developmental disorders, things like autism. Many of these diseases have a circuit basis to them, and therefore being able to model these things using a circuit to work with. By developing this simple sort of in vitro type of circuitry, we think that it'll be a much more informative system for beginning to extract some of the basic principles about how circuits actually operate. And this information hopefully will give us a much better understanding of how our brains work.
We're looking very much forward to the publication of our paper in eLife.